Yeah. Awesome. Thank you. Vai.
Rock me, baby.
I'm gonna come up and Tyler, gonna get paid first.
Welcome, guys. The first matchup here over at Monday night weekend.
Go ahead, man. Go ahead.
Macklin Fernandez versus Darius Stadden. Macklin wins the leg.
Broke is on rent now. Nice break there.
All I can really hear is music. Afternoon, ladies and gents. Adam and Christos will be commentating. I think we're too close.
No. These mics are not working very well. Yeah.
Okay, Christos, how do you see this match panning out?
It's going to be a bit of a battle here.
That's quite a good time, I'm sure.
I heard Darius been practicing quite a bit.
With the one and only, the big one, Rusty Wheeler.
Yeah.
There's been a few stories about that, but I think Darius is sponsoring Rusty now, so I don't know how authentic they are.
Another sponsorship for the Stadden Q's brand. Anyway, we've got Adam List on the mic helping us out today. He's got his big matchup coming up, 6 o'clock with Andy Barnett. How are you feeling, mate?
I'm feeling pretty tight, but I was going to stay home and relax a bit, but I can't really. I'm too anxious to get this match on, so I thought I'd come in, relax, and have a beer.
Yeah, I'll be getting pretty antsy too.
And that one's got one problem down there, he has to deal with that room.
Yeah.
Pick it up here, get up to that, to the top left pocket. Get the right angle on that. He should be able to disturb that. I don't see this being too much of a problem.
I might be looking at opening that bag up as well. What's the yellow? Listy, this is that other camera we've just put in.
Oh, yeah, beautiful.
Got a bit of a side view.
What's the other view? Straight on. Excellent, very good. Okay, Mac, I'm just going to pop this yellow, give him two.
Ali and Ruben from
that's an excellent shot, really.
Phone Medic, and he's working very hard all week to get this set up done, guys. I've been calling him Nerds all week.
Yes, thank you, Ruben. Who's been working hard? Ruben and Mihaly?
Ruben and Mihaly. I've been calling him my little nerds.
Thank you very much. Ruben, if you're listening. And Mihaly is standing right beside me.
Mr. Tech Medic. Second visit. Ali.
It's a bit warm in here, Christos, do you think?
Oh.
Turn the aircon down a bit, or?
Mate, what these cunts fucking doing? Turn the aircon down. Oops, can't swear. They'll take us down. I'll just turn that one on.
Christos has just sat himself out for that. That's an excellent shot from that one. Mate, you're back from your 30 seconds.
I wonder if that red goes behind that yellow.
I'd say that's on. Barry's on the yellows though, mate. Is that on or not?
Yeah, it is on.
His computer. How many viewers have we got? Give us some feedback, guys, on the volume of the commentary, if you don't mind.
Yeah, people are saying they're too quiet. How's that? Is that a little bit better? We're just trying to keep it a little bit quiet so we don't annoy the players. 30 seconds. Sorry guys, it's our first time.
Just tried to slip the white in there behind the yellow. Not a bad try.
You need to be a little bit louder. You're
not okay. I'm going to keep it forward because we're close to the table.
you know, like if you skim off that black there.
He's still got a first. He needs a good first visit here, Mac. I mean, he's a reason to stuff up. I've done it many, many times myself.
Yeah, from this angle.
He's playing at the right way, I think.
Absolutely perfect. Yeah, great shot.
Second visit.
I was thinking about going the other way. Maybe you'd be able to hit the ball a bit flatter, but then I noticed the black might have been in the way. Definitely the right way.
Control that beautifully. Great shot. 1-0, Mac. Very happy for him, and he's given it away. What's up? That's amazing, Christos. That's the technology. The technology these days is just—it's genius. Well done on that one. Give yourself a pat on the back.
That was all me, not Holly.
I reckon this guy's got the best racks in the room. I reckon he just spent a good 30 seconds to a minute, perfect.
What about you? You reckon you're going to let him drag him tonight?
No, mate, he's barred.
Machine, mate.
You go
all this hard work paid off.
You don't have these hard to here. Can you go outside and see if they're alright?
Yeah, well, it's definitely
yeah, on his ball here.
Center right pocket. Definitely be taking the odds. With me.
Yellow ball's in play.
Definitely.
It's only got one real issue here I can see, and that's the yellow next to the red in the middle of the table.
Has he landed too straight on this though? Nope, there's a little bit there. It's got a little bit of a land on that.
He nearly fluked it onto that middle of it, onto that yellow I was talking about.
I think he's on this.
Yes, he's on that, but he's fast digging himself a hole. That was all, that's all derivative from his first shot, really. He's getting too straight on that yellow in the corner.
Yeah, didn't leave himself much angle on that one down the end there either when he had to pump it in.
Slide that red down the rail.
A little bit of top, he'll cover that yellow that goes in the corner by his other red. Shot to nothing.
Shot to nothing.
30 seconds.
You can tell we practice with each other. Very hard to get on. Although if he pops
maybe
this
not.
Out,
he can dislodge this red now. Or sit on it.
Yeah.
Whatever he wants to dislodge it. Really good shot.
Play that well. It's actually a good angle to get better than this one.
And he wouldn't be going for this. That red is that. That red's not on. That's the black. Is that red on or not? I can't see.
He doesn't as you look from the top.
Wait. It's hard to see from this angle. I think it's on. It must be on. It wouldn't be going down, I'm sure.
Although if you land.
Hello, Jody. What's going on?
Doy, there again.
And
Barker.
A few people here to support this match.
I should have done what I did, Christos. Just make a little video and drum up a little bit of force into it. Apparently that video was a big hit. Everyone loved it. Certainly a lot easier up here than it is out there, so I'll try not to be too critical. I've got to get out there yet, so.
Neil Mequin.
Big break from Mequin. Looks like it will be the Reds.
Got a message through YouTube, they might be taking the video down because of music.
So what's that mean? You got to get rid of the music?
Yeah, just turn the mic over one that should allow less music through.
That's ridiculous, what a joke.
It wasn't even that loud. Send me a message if that's a lot better, guys. It's our first time.
Oh, Chetty slapped it, though.
They're all there. That red. The yellow still looks on in the corner. Yep.
Everything's on, both balls are on.
That's still on as well.
He's pulled that up a little bit short. I see more golf here.
I would have gone the one on the rail there. How about yourself?
Hmm?
I would have tried that one on the rail there.
Yes, absolutely.
has got to come back this way.
So he didn't commit himself to that. You either had to run into the ball and see where it landed, or
yeah,
try and come off the rail and get back on it.
Bit of a safety here.
Macklin gets chance two.
Both those reds look like they're on to the corner pocket there.
Yes, I'd say so. He's missed that by a bull's rule.
Lucky enough to go follow that in off, wasn't he?
I think he must have been going for the long double, Christos.
Last few shots, a little bit of a slap fest.
And take three, Macklin.
We wish Andy misses those tonight, don't we, mate?
So what?
Wishes Andy misses those tonight, don't we?
Oh. Now, why would I wish that to happen, Christos? That's very nasty. We don't appreciate it. Doubling this back into the middle, I think. Be a good shot if he gets it. Hasn't left that too badly. I don't think Derry's got a lot on here. I'll just slide this down to the corner. That's his shot. Just wants to dead weight this to the corner.
Made that nicer, a bit more smoother there, skewed that well as well.
And that's ooh, not good.
Really,
he really needed a little bit of bottom check on that, not bottom running, just to keep the ball over the other side of the table.
Still. Is that because of the game? Oh. What do you mean?
This guy's talking to you, this thing.
Hmm?
Someone's asking you questions here. Oh, let's just pick up.
Tommy Clark, table looks slick. Yes, it is, mate. I've ironed it about four or five times today, fixed up the rolls.
And someone's asking you. Great comments, guys.
Yeah, look, I can't.
I don't know who that is.
Guys, I can't really talk up because we're too close to the players. And I don't want to tell people how to play their shots, and they haven't even played their shot yet, so. Pool mate, who's that? Come on, pool mate, tell us who you are.
I think I missed you. Is that English enough for you, mate?
He reckons you're speaking Cypriot. We'll be speaking a bit of that at the end of the year, hopefully. Yeah. I already know a few words. Swearing, mainly. Well, Macklin's got a difficult little first shot here. He's played that very, very well. Nice shot, Macklin.
Is that better, pool mate?
Yeah. See, I think that was a mistake. I think he should have gone the other ball first. The other ball was the way to go. And just leave that last one. Dribble it and run the ball past the black and you're out.
Yep. He's got a good shot there. He's giving him a shot.
Pretty sure he wasn't going for that, but he's got a result. All right, 2-1.
Keep the comments coming. It's coming. It's our first time. We don't know how to yell into this thing. Might turn the volume up a little bit.
We're actually virgins at this. Some feedback would be good, though. I'd like to know whose voice sounds good, whose doesn't. Mine's probably a bit better than Christos's. It sounds a bit squeaky.
Anyway, we were talking about that before. We just went down to the Nationals for Black Ball. Pretty excited. This team made the first A men's team. But on this team, he finished third in the room. Yes, one frame from first.
It was definitely enjoyable down there. The pockets were a little bit tight, but everything else, I think the table conditions were quite good. A few rolls here and there, but that's a given.
Yeah, bar 8. It was a good venue, wasn't it? Nice and big.
It was. The staff were excellent.
Yep.
I think we should maybe send a couple of staff members here down there to learn some etiquette. I'm just joking. Good break, but he's come up dry, I think, hasn't he?
Yes.
I'm making a big chance here on the yellow.
And so we're off to Cyprus. Congratulations, Lucy.
What about Dane and Dane and Vincey?
Yeah, Dane won the singles.
What a magic tournament! Queensland ladies won the teams event. It was successful all around for Queensland, really.
Vincey Dane played in the grand final of the singles. Vincey knocked out McCartney. What a match that was! Vincey loved it.
5 pimples. I don't know if Jake's ever been beaten 5-0. Thank you very much, Adam. And Stubbo, chill out a bit, mate. Sit back and have a beer or something. Come in tonight and support Lissy. Okay, what's up? Smack one on it. Some of the reds.
Thanks, guys. Who is pool mate?
He plays pool mate. He's from Australia. Plays pool.
Started off pretty well.
Right. I think they both had a little bit of a nervy start here.
I just feel like the last few shoes have been slapped at, that's all. Chewing off the rails always hard.
He's got to do something with this yellow close to the rail. I think he's got a little double ladder. Broken it out. He got the perfect angle on that. Let's get through. from here, take the ball over the bottom corner. Yellow to the middle net.
Or we can just dip it.
The black will be going into the left middle.
Sorry mate, just having technical issues. Sorry.
No, he broke that one out. Mm. Good shot, good out.
Good out.
Derry. Wait until this frame, I think we've got another cigarette.
It's actually queuing him a lot more smoother the last couple frames.
Yeah, they'll need a few frames to settle down, I'm thinking.
But the Mac one
Derry looks like he's just got himself a beer, so. That's always good to calm the nerves.
Macklin does have a big break.
Not quite as big as Brett Broderick's. Brett Broderick's got a bigger break than Macklin, I think.
I love the way their leg comes up, though.
He told me it was clocked at 39 miles an hour. Not kilometres, miles an hour. That's massive.
We're in Australia, mate. We don't use miles.
That's what I told him.
Oh, killer break.
Straight in the corner. That's a bad break. It's all good to have a great break, but you must be able to control the water. That's very difficult to do. Hey, Derry, just with the one shot. I think they're playing world rules. Are we playing world rules here, or is it world rules or black ball?
No, we're playing world rules, mate.
Cool, mate. Brett's got the biggest break in the
world. What's that? Cool, mate. Alright, so he's a Queenslander. We'll work that out about him.
I reckon it's Brett or Joey.
Send in a couple of clues, mate. Give us a couple of brain teasers to work out who you are.
Send us a nudie pool, mate. Come on, mate.
With the username like Pool, mate, I reckon you're from Ipswich. That's my little hot tip.
Mish Anderson says good luck tonight, mate.
Thank you, Alicia. Let's bring in some more of those wonderful cupcakes you make. They're unbelievable. They're actually making me fat.
Not the cupcakes, mate.
Not the cupcakes, it's the beer, isn't it? Can you get back on this other rhythm? Here he is.
Benin, Benji. Anderson just walked into the building.
First shot we got coming, let's say a little plant, yellow to yellow.
Yep.
The top right hand corner. And maybe the yellow ball that's in the middle.
This ball's a little bit heavier, it's just going to hit it a little bit off center.
Not even behind that. Beyond.
Yep.
Played the plant, nice shot back.
Nice shot.
Might have got a little kick there. For those of you who don't know what a kick is, it's a bad contact between cue ball and object ball. Generally, it's a bit of chalk that's on the ball, usually from the break.
What do the Americans say, mate?
The Americans call it a skid, because that's the reaction that the object ball takes after the bad contact. We don't do what the Yanks do, mate. We do.
Pretty good, mate. We've got 45 people watching the first stream. Pretty good,
mate. A little bit too hard, but you can work this out.
all that time and money's
cut that in and come off a couple of rails, which he probably will do.
But we've got to give a big thanks to, again, Techmatic and Michael McLeod. He's come up, offered to ref both games for us. Very, very thankful. Thank you, Michael.
To the corner and just screw it back six inches or so.
Yep.
Should be 3-2.
Just screw with this one.
Just screw it back 6 inches. That's yep. All you really need. Am I talking into this thing or that?
That.
So that's just okay. I've been talking into the wrong mic. There you go.
Yep, made that pretty good. Shot. 3-2, Meg.
3-2, smack one. Oh, poor mate. Are you a Gold Coast boy? That's right, if he's not happy, mate, he's going to love me later. I'm going to give him a big kiss and a cuddle when he turns up today and say, all the best, my friend. 3-2.
3-2.
Just avoids the middle pocket with the white.
Spotted?
I think that's dry anyway. Oh no, he's got a ball.
I think one went in the middle, mate.
Yellow. Okay. So yellows are definitely the ball.
Yeah, absolutely.
He's got a first shot on yellow, so.
Make sure he makes this. Yep. Get himself a pretty good angle to get back down to this end of the table.
From the jaw there.
Nice use of the jaw, using all angles.
That was nearly an excellent shot. Poor mate. Poor mate is reading. Well, I was thinking, Ipswich.
I just think he played a little bit rushed there. There was no pain about that yellow that didn't go in that corner.
Well, it nearly worked out perfect, didn't it? He nearly played a very good shot there, but
you would think
could be in for a little sneaky here, I'd say.
Yeah.
I don't want to talk too loud. I don't want these guys hearing me.
30 seconds.
Yeah, nice shot, Macklin.
Wait, they can't even hear us.
Who?
They can't even hear us when we're talking in here.
Well, Macklin could hear me before. I saw him turn around and smile. He does have ears like a wolverine, though.
Well, we got Woodman Q just walked in, guys. Mr. Woody. What key are you selling today, mate? Nice shot. I speak too early, sorry guys. How are we looking? Maybe Rob's a senior, be right.
Pretty good angle there, B. He gets this right, he can disturb the red and the black. Which he's done beautifully, magic shot.
Macklin. He's landed pretty good on that. I wonder if that red goes off that black. Great angle, great shot, Macklin.
Yeah, he's got to get back down here though.
What do you reckon, 3 rails?
That is not going to be easy. Needs to just miss the left middle. Yeah, so there was a couple of shots ago. I don't know if he needed to break that ball out. I thought that would, he could have just slid that into the middle pocket.
That's what I was thinking.
The second red down to the corner. Yep. I don't know if it was necessary to break it out, but anyway.
From here, it looked like it did go. Left it out here.
Macklin's just decided to put some distance between the balls, which is always a good option. You have very little left. Put distance between the balls.
Mate Hughes is the personal thing.
Definitely Woody on the Hughes there.
How you going, Dallas? Good to see you in the comments, mate. Glad you can hear me. What have we got here? We've got a double on for Macklin. Didn't want to take the risk. I don't think he's lefting that outside yellow, so I think that's a pretty good shot. Must have been close to frozen.
Yes.
Huh? Cupcakes here. There you go, Connor. Good.
Thank you.
How's it going on, buddy?
Thank you. Going back tonight?
Woody.
Woody.
Oh,
cool. You have a chat?
Karen Coates has just declined to commentate. Have a go at it, Woody. Don't be a sook. I've got to go and have a smoke soon, anyway.
Why would you drink beer, Mr. Adam Walsh?
Nice shot from Macklin there. He's made Derry waste one shot here, and it'll still be a difficult out, so. Black ball's on the rail.
These shots are very difficult to judge pace. He's going to push it out a bit.
He's played that very well.
Yes.
You just dribble this in, Neil Christos, and he could cut that with a bit of left-hand side and actually dislodge the black from the rail, if he chose.
River Billius makes good table, mate. He can run it down the end.
Well, he can leave himself on the rail and just screw into it. Done.
Shot.
Good shot. Call that too soon, he's missed it. I call that the little bubblehead. Macklin's got a tough little shot here. Very makeable, he makes these all the time. Didn't even touch the sides, that one. Good shot. What's that, 4-2?
4-2. Nice break from Maccas. He's just going out for a smoke, mate. He'll answer your question in a little bit. Shooting with confidence now. She's got that one top red to look at. And I'm pretty sure he's left himself some good angle there.
Hey Walsh, is that music coming through a bit too loud?
Great shooter from Macklin. Looking copper on the cue now. Take this one over the bag. A little bit too much, so not enough.
Know about that shot there.
If he dribbles his red in. Just gotta have a hard black, that's all.
Can you hear what I say? At all?
Oh, good.
No, because that's
a good shot from Mac right there.
Too loud, but people can hear us. That's a really good shot there, Mac.
Yeah, great shot, mate.
It's all you had. Thanks, Subbo. Just trying to get the music right because we had a message from YouTube saying that our video might get retracted for copyright purposes.
Ooh. All right.
Terry's got a bit of work to do here.
No shot, unlucky to break that yellow out.
Oh,
It's a bit first lucky there.
That yellow. Still got a bit of work to do.
It's a big shot here. Just do spread up.
30 seconds.
He's got a two problem ball there as well, so interesting what he tried to do here.
Yeah, couldn't do much more than that. Give back on the hard black and hope to get another visit at the table. Did that well?
It's a good shot there. Even though I didn't put it, there is still a lot of bit of work to do here.
Can't talk back there. They can't hear you, mate.
A bit. Should be 5-2 here.
Frame away. Frame Fernandez. He leads 5 frames.
Always hard there. Three red yellows on the rail, and then Magwin blocked that top pocket. Was there to make this thing a little bit more difficult?
Pretty good, we got 54 people watching.
That's it, 200, mate.
Interesting to see how many people we get touched on.
You guys like this side camera? I'm really liking it. It's a little bit lag, got to fix a couple things on it, but I really like that view.
Paul spotted.
Big bank there, there.
Red balls nominated.
Choose some reds.
Red balls in play.
Oh, missing yellows. Just got to think about that right red block by that yellow. Down in my right hand side pocket. Going to go nicely this frame.
And here's the big man list back.
Well, the three nicely.
Welcome back, Cotter.
Thank you, sir.
Hopefully this red go off that yellow. Yeah, great shot. A bit stiff.
Really should have ran through that. What are we at? Still 4-2 or
5-2 now.
5-2 to Macklin. Shot from Macklin there, he looks a little bit more comfortable.
Yeah.
And quite a difficult plant here. But if he gets this plant, the first yellow will naturally. No, he's not going up. For the snagger, and he's left the white well. He's bridging over this, it's still not easy. Granted.
That's what I was thinking.
Total snooker granted.
This frame now is looking very good to go 6-2.
Yeah, there's a terrible shot before there from Gary.
nearly a good shot there, a little bit harder and that would have been a good shot. He has to play this down to this corner now and try and get in front of that red ball. I think going any other way is a bit silly. Flick this down in or over. If you pot it, the white ball will come back the other side of the table where the yellow is now.
Yep. He's covered that pocket there.
Has he covered that though? No, there's a pretty big hole there. I can see Derry having a crack at this.
Yep.
Nailed it and he's perfect on the double. Not a bad shot.
Yep,
5-3, and that really should have been 6-2. He's given that one away, Macklin. That happens. That's pool. The boys are playing nice and quick.
Yeah,
it's good to see. Good. They're not messing around in between shots.
A lot of snookers happening.
They're not taking an excessive amount of time, which is irritating. Referee is normal, is meticulous with his rack. Macklin's thumped that and lost the white again.
Massive break. He's just lost the white. Twice now. One visit only.
You guys got a function here tonight.
No, but I was just looking at that. I might have to go and help her at the bar.
Go over to the bar, mate. Dana's new. I'll look after this. Okay, Derry's on red. He's only got one problem here that I can see. It's that red down here, right next to that yellow on the right bottom. He's rushed that. I think for yellows here, everything looks on. Just a matter of connecting them properly. Just drop this into the middle and then run that rail ball down to the bottom right corner. Or screw it back to the middle and you play the other middle next. That shot really well, he just missed the pot. I think concentrated too much on the white ball, which happens a lot. We all still make that mistake quite regularly. Missed it, I think. That yellow's under the middle. Yes, it is. is white. We'll be travelling very, very close to that red ball over the top right corner. Possibly even going off. To the corner, nice shot. Very well played, Macklin. Shot, and that's on. 63. Macklin says, like taking candy from a baby. What's the go with the songs in the background? I don't get it.
Our music.
Yeah, what about it?
They can hear the music in the background.
Yeah, so what?
They want you to put some Justin Bieber.
Okay. Well, look, we'll see what we can do for you, pool mate. Don't get your hopes up though, man.
Yes, I'd love one, please.
Up the front.
They take it easy. You know how you get after cup golds.
Reds are looking pretty good here.
Yeah.
Still got a little bit of manoeuvring to do, but can't see any dramas. Nice looking troll, that one. Yeah, blacks on and a multitude of pockets.
Cheers, mate.
Well, ideally, you could just punch this in and get onto that red down to the corner next. Down to the right corner would be the shot. Unless it goes to the middle, it might go in the middle.
Down to this corner.
Okay, yeah. It's got a hold for that black though now.
Yeah, good top corner. That in the way.
Shouldn't be a problem. And beautifully done.
Yeah.
It's at 7-3. Macklin pumps that into the throw. I like it. He's looks a little bit more confident now and more free flowing.
He's doing a lot better.
He's just given out his first high five. Macklin's happy.
just had a bit of a break there. Back on now. Back with a massive break. Got a couple of block problem doors there, try and probably break that one out now. That's a map. Big man Ollie to come over and have a bit of chat with Christos. Listy's gonna have a bit of a break. Guys, I'm back. What's happened since I've been gone? I don't know. What's going on?
I think Derry had a pretty big chance, for a couple of big doubles. Didn't cue the last ball very nicely, so Macklin's a chance here. He's got a difficult shot to counter these two reds. He was up there, but White's only on the top rail.
Picked it off.
So guys, well, who's Macklin?
He's got a pretty good result there, Christos. And the white boot is trying to escape. Couldn't have landed much better, actually.
Yeah.
Very lucky.
Tapo's queuing here.
Yeah, I think he's playing safe here. Too much. No value in going for the out there, Chris, so it's just a heavy feeling.
Thanks, Chris Collin and Vince C. Big Mac special. What happened down south, mate? Every time Mac went out at the table, we say, go on, mate, double mac and cheese.
Legal to see your double mac and cheese here, Chris.
No nuggets, though. No nuggets.
Even if this one in the middle, leaf of black goes neatly, he's still got a really big job trying to get on the top red, so...
Have a look at the side camera, see if we can see the angle a little bit better.
Yeah. No, backwards! So, I mean, he actually got a pretty good angle here now to go around the rails and end up on the sort of top left side of that top red.
Yeah, doesn't mind going around the table, old Mac.
Yeah, so side rail, bottom rail, side rail, and just float up.
Okay. Ooh, he's got a little bit of a kiss. Crowd goes well.
The crowd likes it. He's playing in front of our own crowd here, obviously.
Bit of our luck, Mac.
Still, he's got to give this nicely. Probably just take his medicine and take a tough of black here. What do I know? He does like to let it go.
No shot. He's going to cue this well. Thanks for the comment, guys. Keep him coming through.
Yeah. Nice finish there. Crowd's happy with it.
Take three, Mac.
Three.
It's good, eh?
Yeah. So a few more people turning up now. We've got big Tony Hodges from North, a couple of girls from Goldie wearing their Barney Army shirts. Obviously looking quietly confident over there.
Tell you what, the support in Queensland's awesome. We saw that down south. All the people that weren't playing came down to support the girls, the men's, the singles.
Yeah, I was talking to DVK the other night and he said that it was not like any other nationals he's ever played in terms of the whole squad turning up to support each other.
That's what it's about. Yeah. That's what's get the teams over the line.
Yeah. Alright, so we're looking to go Reds here.
A bit of a cluster though, in the middle there.
Reds, mate. He's a little erratic sometimes, so he might even have a dip of these, but personally I'm probably just looking to pot a couple and maybe come with that bottom left bag.
Yep. Although, But he might have left himself a good angle to go into the pack, but ran that a little bit too much.
Yeah.
I did iron the tables twice today.
Good to see you, mate. It's going to happen every day.
Nice little Charlie.
Tough position here for Mac. He probably wants to try and get a bit more control with this bottom right pocket. I'm not sure if there's enough room for him to poke that inside yellow under. Looks like he's having a bit of fun. He's got plenty of room. Left yep. Pretty safe.
This might be a long one, guys.
Commentator's dream, these frames.
Not on these tables, Derry.
Charlie here,
can't really
see
from
him
on the side,
but just needs to get a rail. Good shot.
Yeah, hasn't it much?
He's quickly sort of turned his frame around to Mac being friendly there. You might see him have a go here now.
Yeah. started queuing the ball pretty well, playing pretty comfortably in the last couple of frames. Back's nice and open.
I think you might see him leave that yellow ball to last now, but he's just got a fantastic
ball. Yeah, I thought he was going to go the rail ball first, but it looks like he wanted to leave that, take the black in the corner. I mean, centre.
Got a bid here for Derry's sweaty pool glove for $50. We'll start that as the reserve.
Lucky you said that. My English isn't that good. I would have said sweetie.
Yeah. It is your second language, Christos. We'll let you off for that. Who is this pool mate? He's very talkative today. Do we know who that is?
Someone told us it's Reddy.
Brent Reed, is it?
Yeah.
Okay. How are you, Reed? Tricky shot to play those.
Yeah. Well, he's covered enough at the back. And it looks like the red will fit in there.
Derry's really got to take these. If that red does pass the top corner, he has to take these balls now if he wants us to change the face of this match. He can't be letting Mackin back here.
So they're going to take this in the corner and take that red first, I thought.
Yeah, I agree, mate. I thought he would have taken it when he had the chance. He had nice angle on it.
That's a Reedy.
Mate, looks like you've got a buy it now option, Reedy, for $50. You can just take the glove.
Mihaly just be 55 Reedy.
Now he's got to get back on that top one. He was nice on it before. I felt like he probably should take it then because he had always had those similar balls to get positioned. Now he's straight on this too to get up there. So
yeah, he's very.
The thing with your problem balls, you kind of want to get on them early and take them when you have a chance.
He did have two awkward bridges from the yellow, so I thought he should have taken that first. Is up.
Okay.
And
pretty good result. We may not be seeing it right, mate. He's not looking at playing it now, which he should be if it's on.
Looks like it is. Let me see if we can see it from the other angle.
He's got a nice one. That's a great shot.
That's even better. More than I know.
This will build a bit of confidence for him here.
Yep.
That's what he needs.
Secure it well. Come back down the table.
Yep.
Shot.
Nice
out, Derry. Well done.
So it's Mac on the break now.
Mac attack. I love the foot when it breaks.
Yeah,
through the leg.
The big kick up on the back. He's all action, isn't he? Wearing the 2018 Moscone Europe shirt as well, which interesting choice of shirt for this match.
He does realise he's from India, right?
Yeah, and he's from England, so he's got the shirt wrong tonight. But today, yeah, he's got a ball.
Oh, it's not ready.
Okay, turns out it's not ready. Whoever you are, pool mate, you've got a glove in here when the match is over. $50.
Come on, mate. Who's pool mate?
Yeah, Tommy,
thanks, Tom.
How are you, mate? You down here doing a bit yourself later, hopefully?
Yeah.
The rest of the VMX break?
a little bit of a stand-up.
It's a bit out of position here. Early.
Actually went to see Tom in the stand-up last Saturday night.
Yep, he sold out on the Saturday night, actually.
Yep. For a not very funny fella, he was pretty good.
It was a great gig. It was good to see a lot of support from the full community as well.
Yeah, it was great. It was like Q Masters went down to see him.
Yeah.
It was great.
There's probably some other supporters there as well. He's a well-known comedian.
I didn't see anybody.
All right, so again, Derry can attack these balls, and coming off the back of that last out, you would think he'd have a bit of confidence, so I think we'll see him have a dip here.
You get a nice angle on that bottom red. Just pump into the other little red and it's safe. Nothing too special. The black goes into the center there.
Yeah, see this bottom one here that's tied up is a bit tricky though, because even if you get on it and nudge it, that yellow on the far left hand side is blocking from the other pocket, so you have to get on it in the same pocket. So
yeah, in the same pocket. So maybe leave it.
Yeah, you almost want to leave that one by the middle in case it doesn't work out.
Yep, take that and then take it back into the corner. Plan 2?
Plan B.
I have plenty of them in my game.
Do we have a Drees runner for this commentary box at all? Or?
Yeah. Just click your fingers at this, mate. Gotta listen to my shitty stuff. What are you drinking?
Tommy's you.
See that? Whoever comes commentates get a beer.
Exactly. It's the only reason I do it. Alright. So he's got that one in the middle, he drops in pretty easily, so he's just gonna negotiate with it. We'll map the other two. It's got a fair bit of angle on this one, I think, so probably be planning to get on the top one first and then come back down, so no, I can't.
Hasn't come enough.
This one goes between the two reds, so yeah, it should be fine.
Does it?
Yeah, it must. I didn't think it did, but the mate's playing.
Yes. It does. Yep, and there you can.
That's a good shot. Now get the dribblers in, bring the white off the rail a little bit. Play the top yellow.
A bit bad bridging here. Should be okay.
The hamper cue in there, I think, just cost him a little bit. He wanted to just check off the top rail. Had he had a full hand on the table and just playing naturally, would be all right. We'll see Derry take this pretty quickly, too. A little bit loose there.
Yeah, a lot better.
Need to take a bit more care and stay close to the balls there, and he's just run down a bit far. And he's had to opt for a safety where he really should have never taken the balls.
Yeah, I think he's just rushing it a little bit.
Yeah.
And even on the easy shots where he should stop, take his time, and land where he needs to land.
That's all that happened there. I mean, those balls were connected nicely. He just needed to be just a little cautious, have a look where you want to be, walk around the table, rather than just aiming for an area.
Yep.
That's what happens.
He's a very quick player.
Mapping it all there up and do a swerve,
They don't call him the king of spin for nothing.
I've never heard that. Okay.
Oh, I just made it up. Yeah, nice shot.
He's going to need another one here.
Don't look like he goes.
Nah, I think he'll have to either play a double or... yeah, actually, it's going to be the double.
Pick could possibly cut into this corner, but it's a...
Yeah, he's going to lose the white as well.
So we got there.
Where Derry's walls are, yes, have to go though. There's no real coverage available.
He's going for the cut.
It's actually not the worst result, really, given that Derry's balls were all in the open, the black's going dead. He was left a little awkward. Save a good kiss there from Derry.
Yes, Vincey, I agree.
Yeah, me too, Vince. Well done, mate. Mabumba.
So he's closed the gap a little bit there. Probably not the way he wanted to close it, but his scoreboard is a lot better than it was. And we'll be breaking in this one. Oh, sorry, it's Macklin's break, is it?
Big Mac attack, the big break, chasing leg. Once again, thanks for Tech Medic Mihaly working hard in the system all week.
Yeah, the Keymaster's live stream is now fully functional. We've got audio, we've got side screens, we've got DJ looking headsets. It's quite the setup in here.
Two very good looking men on the mic.
Eye candy for the tribe of women in here. There's all of about six of them, anyway. They're all impressed.
Joe Smarter's move down south, mate.
Yeah.
Oh, yes.
So,
Vince, you must play a winner.
Vince, you had a crack over tournament down south.
Did, yeah. Made the finals of the men's, playing his friend and teammate DBK.
Yeah. It was very awkward. Like I said, the support down there was awesome. We were all there to watch it, but no one cheer.
Yeah, it would have been a very awkward match for you boys. I guess because you had a few Queenslanders here and there, that's about it.
His dip bell of mid-frame.
But yeah, it was a great tournament for Queensland and for Blackpool. We were bringing the game to the forefront. Everyone who played in the event said it was a great event. Atmosphere was great.
Yep. Both games are good.
Yeah.
Room for both.
Exactly. There's room for both codes. There doesn't need to be all this infighting between the two codes. They can coexist quite easily. So. I think he can squeeze it and take the bag. I don't think he can make the ball. Oh, sorry, I thought you were talking about in the bottom corner next to the red. Rail first and off the red, and then squeeze it down into the pocket. I'm not sure if he can make it, but he can certainly get coverage. Do we have a viewer? Do you know how many people we have on the stream? Or
we were hitting over 50 before.
Okay.
53.
Okay, that's not too bad for the undercard match as well. So we've got the big main event on later on, which will be Andy and Listy, which will be a great match. One of the best matches I think Andy will have played up here.
Who is his pool mate?
Yeah, we're not going to comment on that. keep that in the chat stream, I think.
Tone it down.
Macca. Nice shot.
Just didn't really... Oh, it's tricky here now.
I thought he went in the center. Maybe not. Are we trying to squeeze that ball with this shot?
Yeah, I think there's no real value in trying to do it with the one in the middle of the table now. Just keep that where it is, try and get coverage on the ground. He's made it.
Yeah.
Okay, shot.
Nice shot.
Obviously went a lot easier than I thought.
Yeah, he hit it pretty well. Those are very hard, those shots. You're going to hit it perfect.
Either got the long one here, or he can drop in the middle and try and hold on the red.
You'll see the same thing, up in the middle. Use the red to hold.
He's done it.
And uses the jaw.
He's throwing the wave up there for a bit of luck, but really, I mean, if he had to hit that, and he's going to probably should have been right, so
yep.
It's not too much of an action.
Nailed it.
Finish there from Macklin.
9-5.
We'll leave you for a sec, Christos, while I duck out for a cigarette.
Mate, you're not allowed to go, but I just bought you a new.
I'll be back. Just go
for
me.
What?
No, let's go for me. Came back for you. Fuck off.
Alright, we got Mike on the mic. Mike on the mic with Mike. Who's the wrong boy? Who's that guy? I guess war boy 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 was taken, eh?
Macklin lost the light there on that break again. It's not a position to be in. Nominated to go, Rhodes.
Do that.
30 seconds. Open table.
Open table.
I think Meg went on reds before. He didn't have a shot on yellow. Interesting.
Ow!
Just popped it. That was a terrible terrible shot. Yeah, Macklin used a hard deep. Some of those hard deeps don't take the chalk. He's walked over in his case. Put a bit of sandpaper on it. Still into the black. Not very easy here. Okay. If the spread goes off the yellow, frees up the back.
Come on, Macklin.
cottage over in Maitland. That's what I thought. Yellow's blue a little bit better. Doesn't do much. Black's covered by two. Both yellows go. Pretty lovely screw that.
It's got nowhere really to play that, you know.
Look at the top pocket.
He's just trying to do too much, I think. Didn't really need to do that.
We'll try a double, maybe. I don't know. Good luck.
30 seconds.
He's going to want to replace the divot.
Oh,
got some luck.
This Macklin love.
That's it for Reyes. Reyes is.
Well, you do need a bit of luck in this game sometimes.
Dairy.
Dude, just shaking
space
it.
Is awesome. Could have been guilty, I think.
Should have taken his time a little bit more on that one, I think. He's set up perfect for the next yellow, but
he put a fucking hole in the table. Bastard.
Come a bit too far there. Didn't want to come up
there. Did with
hard.
The whiteboard today, Derry?
I don't know whether he's had much practice with these breakups.
Maybe. That's a good point. They're a little bit heavier. They tend to travel a little bit more.
There's a close double there. We left him nice in that red.
It's all in the center. Doesn't have too much. Slow roller it in. Then on the other yellow, even if he doesn't get it, he'll leave him pretty safe. Enough doesn't look on, let's have a look at that. That should be safe here.
Didn't think about the other pocket.
Back with love, there is love in this.
He's got a lucky again there. Good safety shot from Derry.
Yeah, nice safe. Shot to nothing. Nice shot.
He's gonna want to play it. Safe, I think.
Yeah, that was shot. Double it inside the red. But all bridging. By 3 feet.
So I'm tap this in here, don't go too far.
Oof. Second visit.
Slow it down, I think, a little bit, Derry here. Well, he's skewing the ball nicely. He's playing well. He's a little bit rushed. Not
he's
so
just
good.
Rolling it. Every shot a bit too far, it seems. Playing it just a little bit too hard.
No shot. Yep.
Nine frames to six.
Nine frames to six.
Hey, Maggie.
Huh? Awesome. Thank you.
Chris is always getting the credit for what Mihaly does around here. Always gets the credit that Christos. We all know that all he does is drink all the profits.
Yeah, but they love me. I just came come back. They duly do action. There goes the prancing leg in off again.
Wide again.
Three times. Megwin has got a huge break.
Got to control this break a bit more.
Yeah. Indira choice again. Res look pretty good. Don't look. The red by the center looks like it goes in. Double check for that. Yep.
Move. He's just rushing it too much. Bro. He needs to slow himself down. Shouldn't be missing pots like that.
Like I said, when he's slowing down, giving the ball, he's playing really well. Had a couple of good outs. Just got to slow it down and just concentrate on the queuing.
Back one more about touching that ball there with his shirt.
Once again, thank you, Michael McLeod, that is. Coming in here, repping the games for us. Red ball's down.
Quite a hard shot here. It's not easy.
Yeah, it looks like we'll take the one on the rail first. Just stun across a little bit. Center. I'll have some later, but you can hear everything I do through that. I shot there. And doing that. Maybe just a little bit of running start. Not extreme. Get back on the black. Nice angle for it. Touching the yellow. That's black. Thank you. 10 seconds now. Into this gold update. Short here. Look at the yellow. Yep. Not too much. Good shot. Should use the other one here. Might use the run long. Yeah. Playing with confidence now. After that, should I probably double this one too? Nice shot. It's a pretty attacking today. It's in a good pool. Those guys are playing pretty weirdly. Looking at the time to start at 6 for the funny match as well. It's Dean Barney. That matchup better be. Both very good plays. Frozen there. Don't think it is. Let's get out here if he wants to go for it. We'll take this one in center first. Doing anything special. I think it's a hard shot.
Good shot there, Matt. Ready?
Good shot. Very confident shot.
They're trying to get position of his balls.
He's going to play at the right pace.
Yep. Every time back in.
Doesn't have to do anything special. The other yellow is pretty easy. No, he's going the other way. Good job. For me, it looks like he had to do fine, but he can get better on that. Nicely on the black. Oh, no. What would I know?
Looks like he's going to take it long now, Christopher.
Sorry?
Looks like he might have to take it long now. This is nice, a little bit of a thin look.
Through the crowd coming in.
Yeah, a few people turning up, it's good. Looks like we could be running a bit ahead of schedule here, too.
Mm. Yeah, we're just saying, not many tappies. It's been nice open games.
Yeah.
I thought he should have taken the ball over the inside the pocket first.
Yeah,
it's a lot easier to get positioning when they're sitting out a little bit from the pocket.
Yeah, I was surprised. I think maybe he was worried that, actually, no, you're right. This definitely way should be on. Okay, now I'm just going to the table thing here. He just needs to be real cautious with this stuff. Like, he's way too high in this one near the middle. He's got to play the check. He's just not getting himself as neat on these balls as he could be.
Yeah.
Just by rushing things a little bit.
what I was saying before. He's slowing down, he's actually doing the ball pretty well. Got a couple of good outs. Positioning's a little bit off today.
Yeah.
But he's potting okay. It's getting him out of trouble a little bit.
He's in pot here. He's putting his whole body into that. It's the thing, he's moving on the cue. Just needs to stay down, I think, for the rest.
Yeah.
And that's the thing, he didn't need that out to be as difficult as it was. As what it was. When he got two high and one in the middle, that's where the problem started. He just comes out to a bit of carelessness. He's actually been in a lot of these frames and he's got himself out of them by rushing these more positional shots.
Yeah, I agree.
I know he's very much a rhythm player, someone who gets into the rhythm, and maybe that's what he's trying to get into, but at the same time, you've got to take the bread and butter out to another level. Anyway, it's 11-6 to Macklin, with Macklin to break.
A lot of players, when they get in a rhythm, they'll take that big shot, try to build their confidence up a little bit.
At the same time, when they're there, though, you have to just be cautious and make sure of them. Particularly when you're down, those frames you can't let go. Difference between 11-6 and 10-7 is big at the stage. So. Big crack to Mac, and there goes that leg you were talking about. They don't go in unless he has a leg kick, ladies and gentlemen.
Macklin, the ballerina.
The bucking bronco, I think he'd prefer. But anyway, we'll go with ballerina.
Yellow.
It's not a straightforward rack. Another tight frame here, I think, see the tactics involved. Is that through there?
He sat down a little bit longer. I think that turned out the way he wanted.
Yeah, big mate.
Does it look yellow?
Yeah, he's going to play it down here. It's a black pocket, I think.
Yeah. He plays at the right pace, cover the bag, two reds and a black.
Even if he makes it. Because there's not a lot of harm in making it. Had he cut that a little thinner, it would have come off the side rail and possibly opened up that one beneath the side pocket. So even there, just needed to make sure that's the right shot. Just wanted it a bit deeper in the pocket, obviously.
Looks like it's still on in the corner.
Yeah, it looks, I don't think he's done too much damage to that second yellow. So, a good shot here. And he's still, the one beneath two reds is still tricky as well. So, and he has to play the one side of our last unless he plans on moving that red. So, it has to be taken the right order. Open them up a bit there. Not sure.
It's a lot easier from here.
It is. It's always a lot easier from here. It's a very easy game when you're sitting behind a microphone, let me tell you.
From Derry, He's obviously, like we said, a rhythm player.
Yeah.
So I'm making him down. Hopefully he'll find some rhythm in the upcoming couple of games.
So it must be touching ball here on the yellow.
Yeah, it must have been the way he's played that.
I don't know. Okay.
Yeah.
Thought it might have been touching ball in yellow. Either way, he didn't have much choice.
Shot.
He says take care, he's got two shots here, so this is the situation, and these are the sort of frames that Derry really needs to take here at this stage. It's
yep.
Crucial frames. He's got to take your time, throw it, knock it out, and should be okay.
Right shot here, he's got two.
Yeah, it's a good shot.
That'll give him confidence in the out, and they're just going to make sure of it. Nothing's really that hard.
Held that and played the left middle, I think.
Like, yeah.
Just over killing things a touch.
Still a lot of touch.
This is a key shot here. Get it on and off the top rail and just try and leave yourself sort of centre of the table.
He's
played that okay.
Good shot.
Yeah, that's fine. Yeah, just judging this. This is a key shot. Judging this correctly. Make sure you don't. Himself awkward on the last red. On the last red. Quite well.
You always have to go this one second last. Great shot.
He's taken his ball as well and done it in a way.
Yep.
You know, he had a bit of safety in terms of playing the double. His dead ball underneath the yellow first. So well played.
He's out.
Yep, so this is the sort of rhythm we're talking about. You see, he takes the balls quickly and maps him quickly. Crucial response here though, that was, we really needed that one.
Derek.
Oh, 11-7 here, let's close the gap to 4 frames. I feel like every time I sit down to watch, Macklin's breaking. I don't think I've seen Derry break yet. I keep going to say it's Derry's break, it never seems to be. The elusive Derry break. Anyway. Yeah, he's having some technical difficulties. Chris, just don't touch the technical side of things, please, mate. Just leave that to Mahali.
Better let me touch the computer.
You're just here to look pretty, mate. Alright, so Macklin breaking at 11-7.
They fixed it.
Chris getting a bit of tech coaching here from his brother.
Now that you know, it's going to knock a lot of those brakes today.
Yeah, okay. So Derry straight back in the driver's seat. Kind of think, yeah, he must. What's he playing this in a fashion that he can open up his other problems? Yeah, he has. It's quite that low. He's a bit unlucky enough to get a better result.
Good first shot.
Yeah.
Just landed stiff.
It always sort of had to come out nicely for him because he's never going to really be on the other balls.
Yeah.
Once he plays that, so still the right shot, I think, but it's just one that has to be played with care.
Good job here.
Yeah. Not all options. I mean, Macklin's still got a tricky play of the table. Yeah, and he's done well there. All he's done is just cut down his options by leaving in Chinese, which is really all he can do. So, I think he's played the right shot there.
I wonder if that yellow goes inside the red at the bottom here.
It goes on the right, into the right, doesn't go the other way, yeah. It definitely goes in the bottom right corner. But he's got to get on it, obviously. Any score predictions for the next match, Chris?
Oof.
It's a mouth-watering lineup with Andy Barnett and Listy. It's been controversial, awesome, to say the least. There's been a bit of a, you know.
We put up a video, guys.
Yeah, wasn't well received, let's put it that way.
Look, it's playing the listy. He's got respect for Andy. Quite likes the guy. Never said anything bad.
Yeah, I think it was taken a bit the wrong way, but either way, anyway, it still should be a great match though.
Yeah.
I think,
how about you? Score prediction?
It's hard. I think Andy starts as slight favourite. If he gets tactical at all, I think we're back. Andy. Listy, if he gets on the run and starts getting balls off breaks, I think he's got a potential to run 5-6 in a row. Not necessarily out straight off the bat, but yeah, once he gets in the rhythm, he's really hard to stop.
Yeah.
I don't think everyone realises how dangerous he can be when he gets into that zone, so I'm really looking forward to it actually.
Yeah. He's a very good creative player.
Yeah.
Good creating out, even when it's not there. Gets those annihilated kisses, run his way, I think he'll win.
Yep, and he doesn't, he never crashes into problems or anything. There's always a degree of calculation when Listy opens up a problem.
Yep.
He knows where, roughly where everything's going to land, and that's what sets him apart from all of the other players.
Good matchup. He played awesome down south, like I said before. Third in the room, one frame from first.
He actually landed on the problem the other day. A bit of luck, but he's on it now. I think he's going to play it now. I mean,
I thought it was just going to wait and screw back off the other one, but took it early.
Mm. Yeah, I think you have to take it now. Just to make sure you judge it off the red. Probably a bit of touch of top right, try and come around the centre table. I don't like trying to screw it all the way back. It's a lot of room for error at that distance.
Here we go. What would we know? We know something.
It's just, you were on it then, and I suppose maybe he's thinking, I don't want to open up that red for Derry if I don't cut out, but still.
Yeah, but if you pulled the yellow, but didn't make it, it's over the back, covering two of his reds anyway.
Derry's just playing safe there. He left a lot for Macklin, really. He could have a go at the double, but again, doesn't afford the easy position to his next yellow.
He might have that in the top corner.
Oh, yeah, okay. He can get past that.
Maybe.
I see you're still playing Michael Jackson in the pool hall, mate, despite many radio stations pulling him. We love Michael Jackson down here. They're all lies, ladies and gentlemen. It's all lies. Alright, so in a bit of trouble. Couldn't ask for much more than that.
Yeah,
it's really. Again, expect Derry to take this.
Yeah. It's come down to, he should have taken that yellow when we thought he should have.
Yeah, I just kind of felt like it wasn't too hard to get back to the centre table.
Yep.
Even having the judge to glance off the red, just hit it with enough pace that you can come out of the centre table.
Yeah.
But anyway. This is what I was talking about earlier. This is good. Derry's taking time to make sure of things, you know, get how he wants to be on each ball. And he seems to be doing that now, so it's okay. Okay, now it's a bit tricky.
Too much angle.
I'd almost just want to screw this straight to the side now. And just even though it would make more tricky position on the black, but just. I thought he'd just screw straight back to the side rail, leave between the two yellows and just leave himself.
Fine, Nick. Off the red for black.
See? Shot. Should get in the frame, really.
But he's laying out. Give himself some rhythm. Mid ring, go through or lay out?
Well, look. If he goes, even if he hits the outside of the yellows, he's more than likely going to leave that red in the middle anyway. So, yeah, I think he's kind of better off just maybe not leaving him touching so that he's forced to play off the ball. But tricky.
So the black's covering that. Even if he skims it, both boys can go opposite ways.
Yeah, I think that might be the shot. Try and just glance off the red, push towards the yellow, and then flick white sort of thing. So, that's not too bad. It's fine. It's a little hard to judge here for Derry.
Yeah.
Sort of flick off it, I guess, sort of quarter ball maybe.
See the dad, rail first. He's right on that. Let's go over with him back in the corner.
Oh,
listen to me, mate.
Alright, so.
So
I think Macron will just,
here.
Yeah, I think he'll just play this, come around the back of the other yellow, just play it as if you sort of one shot really. There's no point in trying to lolly it or play it like that, exactly.
Beautiful. Screw off this.
Yeah, just run through this, come on. He extends his lead to
7.
That's good.
You're ready out your beer, mate. Where are you going?
I'm back to
just push the wine
into the jaw. Ali, why don't they go down
there? Yeah, that's what I'm
Hey Chris, money bun is match. We've got about 3k on each side, so a 6k pot. Straighten off. Looks like yellow's a good ball here. Going through it difficult. Welcome back to Old Town. In off the break.
Derry. Oh, I missed another Derry break. I swear that doesn't exist. Okay. So.
30 seconds. Yellow ball's in play.
Definitely thought yellow's were the ball there.
Yep. Yeah, definitely. What would you do if you went
good shot.
Yeah, great shot there. So just gets in that bottom line. Play that down. In the middle above the flat now, I'd say. I mean, yeah, I think he's. He could screw back if he'd like to, I think. I'm not sure if he can. We had some questions on the stream chat there, Christos. How do you flick back to that? We think the pot is 6,000, Chris. I'm pretty sure. Is it 6 or 7,000? 6,000. With Listy and Barney. Okay.
Very happy to leave.
Shot there from Derry.
Good shot.
He's definitely playing himself back in this match. I mean, still 5-frame deficit, which is hard to make up at any level.
Can't give up. Gotta make Macman earn these last frames. Chrome out of rhythm. Do what he's been doing the last couple.
Yeah.
No shot.
You've
got to have a plan here.
Yeah, it's
a good shot.
Yeah, I don't mind that. I almost just take a pocket and just, yeah, just again put back and hit that bit hard. See, a little bit more care, I'd like to see from Darius, shots like that. Just a tough more care. Like, the idea was right, the shot was right, just play with it.
That's right. He took his time, made his plan, and it was a good plan, but then when he had time to cover the bag, he rushed it.
Yeah, see, now that yellow's open for back, I'm not sure what it's like for this one, but I think if you just dribble that in the middle, again, getting on the back's going to be the key here.
If he takes this, that yellow, big pocket, in the same yellow where the yellow is.
Yeah.
It's just where he was with black.
Adam Walsh has turned up. He's quickly becoming April promotions around here. He's shared more fucking, sorry about the cursing, shared more links to this than I've seen.
He's a very sexy man.
Great shot there from Mac. He's tragic. So now he's got, he really can put his white ball wherever he wants. It's a matter of where this black's going to go.
You think?
He can screw off the side rail and look at putting in the top corner. All right, man. Yeah, Mango didn't know. It didn't look like it did for him.
He's going to try and run into it.
Yeah,
and
yeah.
This could end up a little bit ugly.
See, I prefer going off the side rail and trying to get it either in the top corner or in the middle.
That's what I would do.
A space to land in. I don't know where he's going to land.
Even shots to run into in the last always works out.
So he's played this, needed to pull up, That was a danger, but it was the right shot, it's just a danger of to hold there.
Yeah, that's what I mean. If you're trying to do that.
We'll see.
Yeah, I want to see Derry's face, where is it? Macko in love. Yeah, Vandy Barnett just walked in.
And some of the Barney Army, was it?
The Barney Army.
Very casual and strong for the singlet.
Got a Woodsy match coming up here. Big one, 40k.
Sorry, who?
Barney versus Woodsy.
Steve Woods?
Yeah.
Okay, yeah. Up here, is it?
Yep.
Yeah, okay.
Right at Kim Masters.
Alright, that's a big match. That'd be a fantastic match. Woodsy's a world class player, and I think, yeah, Barney is as well, so that's.
Gotta get all the boys backing Barney.
Yeah, yeah.
For that one.
We'll probably get a few of the New South Wales boys getting behind Woodsy as well, though, I guess. Yeah, he has played for New South Wales.
Time running.
Okay, so it looks like we've got a toe over here.
Nice shot.
Nicely played there from Ackley, yeah. These balls are sitting quite awkward, so
you can make
this Charlie quite easily. Wanted to come off the edge of it a bit more than that. So we can dribble this one in the middle, move the black up a bit.
I didn't like the reds. They were a little bit awkward. This was.
Okay.
I was gonna say just lay up on that. Now it's opened it up.
You'd have to say Derry's favourite in this frame now. With nowhere really safe to leave without one.
Mac loved these.
You know, we go making this. We'll see him hit this a bit of
this. Makes this. The snapshot. Derry's face.
You can either go clean or off. Ooh. He's had a cool cracker.
That was a shot.
Well, I mean, it's not too bad result with your black going on the side rail a bit, so. So, Terry's still going to have to negotiate a tricky-ish break. Looks like he'll be playing the double from where this landed. And straight on it, so I think he'll just seeing where he wants to play the double from. Everyone's different here. Looks like he wants to suck the white out of the way a bit. No, okay, he's actually...
I don't like that.
Mm.
I don't like that at all. It's no, very negative.
No, he makes these pretty frequently, so...
I don't mind his other touch selections with the safeties, the snickering.
Yeah, like what he's tried to do is to leave it so it's only going to double kiss, but maybe when he plays these pretty frequently, maybe we're playing off the rail here. Yeah. So I think Derry's going to just leave him.
So Mac will love. Look at Derry's face.
Yeah, I think he's okay though. Yeah, he's fine. So, I'll make it 12-8.
Frames now. Fernandez leads 12 frames to 8. I'm going to take a 5-minute break.
Alright, so taking a 5-minute break, guys. Get a break from me and Christos for 5 minutes.
Only 5 minutes, guys.
Frames late. Hernandez leads 12 frames to 9. Go on, Macklin.
Alright, we've got Andy. How you doing, mate?
Yeah, good, mate. Looking forward to the game tonight.
Should be a good one. Feeling a bit pumped?
Yeah. Got up this morning and got them game day butterflies. Looking forward to the match, and it's just the hours just drag on and on during this day, and then you just want to get ready for the start of the game. How you produce the goods.
Yeah, should be cracker. I'm feeling those jitters. I'm not even playing.
Yeah. Sometimes people say it's the easiest place to be in the middle where you're playing, because you're the one who's just doing the work, so you're in the zone and you're not really thinking about anything, just putting the ball. Yeah. As everybody else is watching on the edge of their seat.
So, you watched much of this one?
Yeah, I watched a bit this when they started at home, and then I've been watching it on the iPad on the way up here. Overall, I think it's probably a fair scoreline at the moment. I had a hit with Derry last night, and he was cueing the ball sort of okay, but he knew he could play better and was hoping that he'd switch on today. I thought the start was going to be key. I thought if Derry could get off to a really good start, then he might be able to run away with the match, but I knew if Macklin got ahead early, then it'd be hard to pick back. So it's looking like that sort of prediction is going to be the way it's going.
Yeah, look, Derry, when he slows down, I think he's playing well. He's giving the ball through well. Just when he speeds up a little bit, he's just stabbing a little bit at it.
Yeah, Derry's natural game is to run around the table 100 miles an hour.
Rhythm.
And then when he does slow down and he starts cueing the ball nicely, he looks very good in patches, but then he'll miss an easy one, and so he thinks he has to start running around the table again. It's finding his right tempo. Once he finds the right tempo and he adjusts to it, he will be a very good player. He misses the easy ones because he rushes, and then he misses the easy ones because he slows down. So it's just finding that balance with Derry. We all know he can pop the balls, and he's a good cueist at times. I don't know how many money matches he's played before and what his experience is like in the money games, but yeah, there's always going to be a tough test with Macklin. We know he's a solid competitor, so if Derry does take it all the way, or if he does sneak the win, then obviously it'll be a very good win for him, but there'll be no disgrace in losing to Macklin if he does win.
No. He's ran that a little bit too much, I think.
Yeah, it's amazing how different, when you're watching it on the TV or on the live stream, how different it looks when you're actually sat there next to the table.
How'd the stream go? Did it look good?
Yeah, it did look good, mate. Oh, it was very clear, very fluent, no jitters.
I'm not allowed to touch the computer.
Yeah, don't touch the IT, mate. Leave the technology to other people. Yeah, Derry here with a little chance to go back within two frames.
So it's seven to Mike. Still alright here.
Yeah, because even if he doesn't go game here, he's got a bit of security there with the black and the two reds.
Yeah.
But we all know Derry's very attacking. As I say, that he covers the pocket. I don't think he intentionally covered the pocket.
I made heaps of those scores today. Nothing I say comes true. See?
Yeah.
Every time I touch it. Mate, I dragged you away from your friends.
That's all good, mate. Yeah, I don't like this point because you're getting so close to your own match. You know you've got to wait for this match to finish. It's like a bit of a, you're in limbo land. You really want to get pumped up for your game, and then you know it could be another hour, another 2 hours. It depends how long this game goes. So you want to get in the moment, but obviously you want to stay relaxed at the same time. So I love the once the lag's done and you get started, I love that bit.
It's
just,
yeah.
it's just the start, like waiting to kick off. That's true.
Too many jitters to actually start running.
It's funny, like, because I get nervous before the game. Like now, I'm feeling a bit nervous, you know, a bit of pre-match butterflies. But literally, once the game starts, it just disappears. You know, like you just find yourself. It's just another game of ball at the end of the day. Like you just focus on that one ball, that one frame, and obviously as you're ticking the scoreboard over, you just want to win the match. Just another game of ball.
What do you think the key is to winning tonight? Seen much of Lister's game?
I haven't really seen much of Lister's game, but from what I know of him through other people's opinions, like I don't really know if he's played a lot of money games in the past, and I don't know if he's played a race of this length competitively. And it's a totally different mindset and a totally different ball game to actually play in tournament pool. Like tournament pool races to six, races to seven. Anybody can perform their A game in a race to seven, race to six. You can't perform at your A game level, race to 21 for the whole match.
Yeah.
And if you can, then you're a Mikkel or a Chris Mellin or a Darren Appleton, and still over a race to 21. I've seen these boys play it, and I don't think they do it. So if they don't do it, then there's not many people on the planet who are doing it. Yeah. Race to 21, very tough mentally.
Good shot.
Stamina for the game has to be spot on. And you're going to miss them silly balls, like it's inevitable on a race like that long. So and you just have to laugh them off and not let it wind you up. And if it does wind you up, it can take a lot of frames to go over that. So in a race to 21, you can miss one ball and it can cost you maybe three or four racks before you know about it. So
yeah, we had the same chat there the night, didn't we?
Yeah.
I think about keeping composure.
Yeah, and that's where obviously I think experience plays a big part in these games. Like I said in the build-up, I've been around the block once or twice and I've played over this race many a time. I don't know if I'm getting any better for it, but I've got the experience under my belt. I love the challenge. The one-on-one challenge is what drives me, really. It's not about the money, it's not about the occasion. It's just somebody challenges you and you take it on, and obviously they want to beat you and you want to beat them. And like I said, it's a firm handshake, look them in the eye, may the best man win. That's all you'll ever get from me.
The atmosphere should be really good tonight. I was just commenting to the guys on your big match with Woodsy.
Yeah, so that one's in the pipeline for June. I've got another match in a couple of weeks with Brett Rogers, the return match from when I played on the Gold Coast.
Yep.
So 2019 is looking like it's going to be a very busy year for me, which is what I planned at the start of, well, towards the end of last year. Me and my wife sat down and we had a good chat about me playing pool this year.
How did that go?
Started off a bit frosty, but yeah, she knows it's something that I love doing, something that I've always done, and now that my hunger's back, she knows, she can see the drive in me that I really want to get back to a good level, and she knows that I believe in myself 100% and I believe that I can be one of the best in Australia. So if she believes, if she knows that I believe that, then she's willing to support me 100%, and you can't ask for more than that.
No, like, you can't.
If things are good at home and things are good off the table, then generally things get better on the table. So, at home we're a real solid unit. You know, we're a great family, two lovely little girls, and they love watching Daddy on the TV. And yeah, they'll be sat there tonight before they go to bed, you know, just cheering me on first few frames, and then Mummy will put them to bed, and she'll sit there biting her nails, and you know, sitting behind the cushion, won't be able to watch. Just peering around like she's watching a horror movie. While you're watching some of my shots, it's like watching a horror movie. So.
I don't know, you played pretty good the other night.
Yeah, I felt good. I felt good on the table. Table was as good as ever. Like, you know, I've played it a few times now on this table, and always impresses me. So, and that's all. Yeah, when you come to play one of these matches, you don't want to be going to some dodgy little side street pub and playing on a table that rolls from left and right and up and down.
Especially for money.
Yeah, and the way things are done nowadays and the way the game's going, everything's done more professionally. Obviously, we're looking at the stream now, and it's a very professional-looking outfit. The table looks great. You know, you guys are doing a great job, and I think there's a lot of people around Australia that are doing the same thing, and it's only good for Australian 8-ball, the way the game's being promoted, the way the game's evolving. You know, a lot of guys are jumping on this live stream and promoting money matches and tournaments. And look, it's amazing, really, because like, when I was growing up and playing the game and I was on the up and up in England, we never had any of that.
No.
If you played a money game or you played a tournament, people had to be there, and if they weren't there, they didn't see.
Yeah, that's true.
That's the way the game's, or the way the technology's evolved, and it's come along with pool. And it can only be a good thing for Australian 8-ball that the more matches there are, the more exposure we get, whether it be in Queensland or Victoria, or by you, or by Jamie Stevens, or by the guys in ACT.
Absolutely.
I don't care who's streaming it and who's producing it. Like, if it's on and I'm not doing it, you know, like, it's a good game, I'll watch it. Like,
yep.
I'll sit at home and watch it with the girls, and they'll say, Daddy, why are you playing? It's not my turn this time, darling, you know, I'll wait for my turn.
Yeah, too right. Had this conversation with you a couple of weeks ago. It's all about getting it out there, get more people viewing it, get a couple of sponsors.
Yeah.
So when we go represent a country overseas, maybe we don't have to fork out any money.
That's it. Yeah, I keep saying to people, it's like, people said to me, any exposure is good exposure, which in a way is true. But I think positive exposure is better than negative. Any live stream money matches that are being done at the moment in Australia is only positive. Everybody's doing it in a very positive way. You know, the matches are being promoted well, being advertised great. You know, the social media is full of great platforms for people to really promote the game in a positive manner. And like I said, there's plenty of people doing it. So the more exposure, the better. And like I said, the more matches there are about, then the players are going to get more and more known, and then that creates a platform for them to get their own sponsors. You know, there's plenty of great players in Australia who want to play for money.
Yep.
They're all saying they want to play each other, which creates, you know, like great matchups. There's a lot of good characters in the game in Australia. You know, a lot of outspoken characters, a lot of quiet characters, so it makes for a good mix.
Yep.
I see a lot of potentially great matches for myself. But you're only as good as your last match, so I'll take care of tonight. I don't really look past tonight. All the games are lined up, but you know, if I lose tonight, then obviously it could be a step backwards before we go forwards again. But I don't plan on losing. I plan on turning up and producing the goods, and as long as I play as well as I can, I believe I'll win. So
it's going to be a great match, no matter what.
Looking forward to it, mate. Thanks for the chat. I'm going to go back and speak to the guys.
Good luck tonight.
Thanks very much for your time, mate.
Thank you. There we go. Barnett got his match up, 6 o'clock I think. Coming into it, playing Mr. Adam List. Should be a cracker. A very good match. Everybody's looking forward to it.
He sounds really good on the...
Better than me, you know. It's my first time.
It's good to have him on there.
English is my second language.
It was a good out from that one before, that last frame.
Yeah,
so
great out.
Talking about the game very much. I think Macklin's finding a bit of fire about him.
Just showed that one. Just a little bit. This yellow look pretty messy down here. Gotta go with this a little bit.
Seems to be putting well there.
Yep.
Yellows are just getting worse and worse. There he should lose this one. If he does a silly mistake, then he might, but I don't see that.
Not sure there. Yeah. Take this red, insert the other one. Yeah.
out of the way. Just pop up a load here. Very hard to hold. Very hard to hold.
He's got a harder shot now on the black.
He's got a very, very unlucky day. He's got a crack. Oh, the shot.
Cracker. It was a good out.
Very good out.
Wrong ball choice in those two reds.
I thought he should have taken the red inside the other one. Easier to hold. Megan's pretty stoked about that one.
That's pool.
That's pool. What a break!
Back from back one there.
My prancing ballerina. Where is this coming up?
Chris really doesn't know anything about technology.
Take me back to the dark ages. There we go. It's coming nicely. There we go. I think it was thinking too much about the position. Forgot about the pot. Barney, good matchup, guys. Can't make it in, definitely turn around and watch it.
He's getting sloppy.
Great shot there. Great shot.
It's going over 3 hours. Game 9.
Should be 10 here.
Look, very impressed with Derry. There was was a good ball a little bit, but it's not letting Macklin run away with it.
Played that sweetly.
Not letting Macklin. Shows a lot of heart. Good shot. Nice out.
15-10.
15-10.
Still not very much in it.
Nope.
I think the game's picked up a bit now as well. We had a bit of a dry spell. There during the middle, I think he got a bit
Boring.
Joey's in the house.
Bill's here too, from the mortgage box. Good guy. Go see him. Need a mortgage.
Come on, Buckers.
Still break. Can't take him anywhere.
Just lost the white there too.
Keep me away from the computer, mate. Oh, we'll stuff that up. What's he going for? Reds or yellows?
Reds.
Reds. Good choice. Should be running this rack, you believe. We'll take the one over the middle now. Run through a bit of running side, get back on these two in the corner pocket. Gives you an easy one in the middle last. Roll through, black center. Nicely done. This one over the back first.
It's pretty easy.
Yep, listen to me. Nice shot, Max. Left himself in the ring. Looks like it.
Maybe not.
Maybe not. Nope, someone just moved in front of me.
It's okay.
Looks pretty straight.
Good job, Kevin. That's a great shot from
Good shot, Max.
Great shot.
16-10.
Come
on, Mac. Good out.
16-10. Can you rewind and check it?
All right, guys.
Sorry guys, just had to check. Derry thought that Macklin broke out of turn.
They thought he broke out of turn.
He thought that Macklin broke out of turn. Wasn't Derry anyway.
Anyway, we sorted that out. Look at me go. Computers, yeah.
Not you. It was me again. Again, you're claiming all the credit.
Wait.
Give me a bit of credit. Come on. Big break again from Macklin. White stayed on the table.
Big break.
Correct.
Is that the ball? Not an easy one to open up though. Gonna get a wash here over here. There's a new promoter of April.
Red Bulls in the light.
Yeah, try and get into detention. How are you, mate?
Good, mate, yeah.
Very good. That was good, yeah, job from Maquin. Sorry guys, we're just talking to Will from Mortgage Box. Whatever you need, go see Will. He's the best. Old fashioned service.
If you're looking to refinance and just looking for a new home loan or whatever you might need, any financials, Will's a man to see.
What's the matter, John? Hey? What's wrong?
17:10 here. Sorry about that.
Getting down to the money end of the match.
Just ran a bit too much on that one again. Trying to get the
I was feeling the pressure now, Mac. Terry's sorry. Things haven't gone his way. Mac has played well. Guys, we've got Will here from Mortgage Box.
Good afternoon, everybody.
How you doing, Will?
Really good, thank you. Excited to be here. Great games today. Some good players, and we're going to see some good action today.
So tell us a bit. What do you do?
We're very proud to be sponsoring QMasters. We look after all kinds of finance needs, mortgages, car loans. You know, boat loans, any boys' toys that you like, and fantastic rates. We've got mortgages starting at about 3.5%, so if you're paying anything more than that, it's worthwhile giving us a call. Go to www.mortgagebox.com.au. We'd be happy to assist.
Will's offered the sponsor for some money to the players or the ref. Thank you, Will.
Oh, you're welcome. Thank you for the opportunity.
Don't you do the you manage people super as well? Planning Box?
Yeah, we've got a sister company called planningbox.com.au. We're looking after people super, insurances, all those type of things, you know, planning to retire. It's always good to know where you're heading, making sure that your retirement planning is on schedule. You know, it's always good to know that the money that's been put away as part of your super is actually working hard so that you can get to a situation where you can retire comfortably.
It was awesome, Mortgage Buzzers, guys. I see him, my brother sees him, he's helped us out a lot. Definitely go down.
So, what do you think about the game today?
Ooh, this one's really over, I think. I think Macklin doesn't have to do much in the next few frames. Even if he loses this one, he's still pretty confident, especially on the two. Next one should be a cracker. two big boys battling it out, race 21. Should start that at about 6 o'clock. Stream looks good.
So, Crystal, tell me a little bit about, you know, it's always watching the game is live is always, you know, the way to do it. You know, streaming is fantastic, but tell us a little bit about the alcohol that we serve here and the food that we've got and what everyone's special today.
Mate, we got a lot of food and a whole lot of alcohol. Everybody likes the bucket deals. We do what? Sorry about that. We got heaps of food. We got Byron Bay pizzas. We got hot dogs. We got Mama's cooking. Mama makes great carbonara. Looks like Michael's going to finish the game here. We got a Marcus. We got the players in a little bit. Come in and see how that went. That's it from us for now. We'll be back in a sec.